I thought I might create a video of some of the ways I'm integrating my Boss GT-1000 core in a direct rig. It's possible this video may inspire some ideas, both for others or possibly for yours truly, as lately I've been contemplating making some changes. I'm mainly curious whether or not I'd benefit from keeping things as is, or if there's any benefit in switching over to a mixer. There's only one reason I'd switch over to a mixer, and I'll get to that later. And I'm wondering if that's enough reason or if the current layout is the best there is to be had. So without any further ado, let me show you what I'm doing with my GT-1000 core and maybe get some feedback. This is the Boss GT-1000 core as seen through its editor software, Boss Tone Studio. There are two inputs and I've got two foot switches set up to toggle between the two input sources. The red light in the middle is for guitar. The blue light on the left is for bull signals. And when nothing is lit, that is the second signal. The flashing blue light, by the way, on the right is for tap tempo. The advantage of using the GT-1000 core over a mixer is that the former is hands-free. The disadvantage is being limited to two inputs. Another advantage is having the ability to stage which signal, A or B, is waiting in the wings, as it were, when the Y or blue light switch on the left is returned to A or B. As for all the splitting going on, it works like this. I'm going first into my not very buffer-friendly soul bender, which then is outputted to a radial shotgun. The shotgun splits the signal up to four times, and here I'm using only three. One travels to a guitar pedal board, not pictured, which then returns to the red input of the Boss GT-1000 core. The second input travels to the Boss SY-200 synth. The switching system, set up as is, enables me to play the synth with or without the guitar. Also, the SY-200 likes receiving a nice, plain, dry, unaffected signal, which it gets from the shotgun, and the fuzz makes little difference. Once the guitar from the pedal board is mixed with the synth, the results can be processed in the GT-1000 core with stereo effects. And the third output of the shotgun is just a dry signal routed to my DAW just in case. The two pedals in the middle of this board are in the Boss GT-1000 core send and return as a stereo return. They are a Von Gon polyphrase and an electro-harmonics looper. So now the synth and guitar can be processed in stereo via these two pedals as well as what's offered in the Boss, all tied together using MIDI and MIDI clock. And the whole shebang sounds something like this.